Officer trainees, so I thought, you know, they should interact with you all so that two, three can come here. So this is Vartika Mathur. She is the professor of assistant professor of zoology and biological sciences.
Hi.
At the Venkateshwara College, often called the Venki College, right? That's the
Venki.
Name of your college.
Yes, sir.
Put your mask and introduce yourselves. Or let's wait for Shivam Ganesia to join.
Shivam is here, sir. And we also have with us my colleague, Dr. Rajendra Pratyar.
Hello, how do you do, Dr. Rajendra?
Hello, sir. Very good.
How do you do? So we need to see Shivam before we can start. Oh, there is Shivam Ganesha. Okay. Hello,
sir,
Shivam.
I'm
how
here.
Do you do? Okay.
Sir, I'm good.
So I'm joined here by five young officer trainees of this batch. So let's start the conversation.
So, sir, can we start?
Oh, please go ahead. Hello.
Good evening, everyone. Hello, my name is Pari Bishnoi, and I'm also from Delhi University. Actually, I've done my graduation from IP College, Indraprastha College for Women, from Political Science Honors, and I'm here. I mean, I got rank 30 this year. And join the Indian Administrative Services.
That's nice. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Good evening, everyone. This is Ashish Agrawal. I'm from Kanpur, Uttar Pradesh. And my graduation is in Mechanical Engineering from IIT Kanpur. And I've also worked in Japan as a design engineer for 3 years.
Wow.
So now I'm...
Wow, sir.
Straight from Mount Sinai to here.
This is Dheera Singh, and I am from the Gorakhpur, Uttar Pradesh. And by profession, I am a doctor and MBBS and MD radiology. And I have done it from the Banaras Hindu University.
Excellent.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Navneet Sehara, and I have done my BTech from IIT Bombay. And right now, we all are in Indian Administrative Service. I'm looking forward to this discussion right now.
Hi.
Thank you, Prasadhan. I have done my BTech from IP University, and then while preparation for UPSC, I have done post-graduation in anthropology, and I'm also from Delhi.
Okay.
So, you know, this is the group of the Society for Social Services, so I thought that, you know, they should engage with those who are trying to compete for the examinations, because they'll be able to connect better. So this is the background here. So over to you, Shiva.
So, sir, can we start our orientation ceremony, inauguration ceremony right now?
Go ahead, start it.
Okay. So, all the power in the universe are already ours. It is we who had put our hand before our eyes and cry that it is dark outside. Reach high for the star that lie hidden in your soul. Dream deep for every dream lead to a goal. A very warm welcome to all the esteemed guests and attendees for their presence in the August gathering to witness the inaugural ceremony of Exodium, the civil service cell of Shri Venkateshwara College. Dr. Sanjeev Chopra has kindly consented to be our chief guest for evening. Welcome, sir. We are privileged to have you with us. You are a role model for all of us. We are also honored to have among us Dr. Vartika Mathur, our dynamic convener. On the behalf of Team Exodium and Shri Venkateshwara College, we welcome you all to official inaugural ceremony of Exodium. Exodium has been through a roller coaster ride from past 9 months. It has been very thrilling journey to begin from the scratch to where we are right now. I think it would not be possible for us to be here without the support of college, students and university. I would also like to share how this initiative come into existence. We have always feel a need of proper guidance for entrance examination. This need gave rise to an idea which result into the cell. At first, it was difficult to connect with the student as nobody believed that it would be a successful. But gradually, aspirants start joining us and the small group turned into a very, very big society. Exodium mean, what the Exodium word mean? Basically, Exodium means to initiate something or to start or of a orator or a poem. As the cell, was to start a new approach to idea to how to connect with the student and how to give a proper guidance to all the students who are preparing for the same. We need a group of aspirants where we all post NCERT video lecture, newspaper analysis, current affair quizzes, and many more on a regular basis. What we did is easily explained by Dr. Albert Einstein. I never teach my people. I only provide the condition in which they can learn. We also came up with an idea of Inspirigence. What basically Inspirigence is, and Inspirigence was our first series in this Corona lockdown. We interviewed various bureaucrats and we got overwhelming response, which was totally unexpected. Matlab ummeed se badhkar support mila hame. Humne kafi kuch kara, but what I learned in this period, it was that we cannot do anything alone. We need a team which should be equally responsible, always there with us, because we human are social animal. I am quite confused to call my team as my team or as a family. It is hard to decide. I feel that it is very special that jahan lockdown mein log doston ko kho rahe the, I got a family here. A family which is always ready to help each another. And basically what is different from others is कि यहाँ पे लोग एक दूसरे के हिस्से का काम भी करना चाह रहे थे, बिकॉज व्हाट दे फील इज कि यार अगला इंसान किस मेंटल कंडीशन से जा रहा है, एंड दैट्स व्हाई दे ऑलवेज ट्राई टू डू अदर वर्क आल्सो. सो वी गॉट दिस फैमिली. आई रिमेंबर द वर्किंग डेज व्हेन आई हैड मीटिंग विद माय फैमिली, मींस विद दिस ग्रुप एक्सोडियम. वी ऑलवेज हैव अ सीरियस कन्वर्सेशन, आफ्टर दैट वी हैव गॉसिप विद ईच अदर. And now I would like to share an experience through a video. So, Shreyash, can you please play that video?
Please reshare the video with computer audio.
Shreyash, I think kuch issue aa raha hai.
Yeah. Please reshare the video with computer audio.
Ritika?
Okay, the audio is still coming.
No, while you are sharing the video, there
yes,
is.
Yes, sir. Got it. Thank you so much. Yeah, I'll just play it again.
I learned that leading a study group isn't just about sharing knowledge about various exams, but also shaping one's personality. By dealing and acknowledging problems, by preaching punctuality, boosting the morale, and meetings packed with brainstorming sessions.
It is very enthralling to be a part of the social media team. It made me a better planner, and I've also realized that the work never sounds like a burden if we take it as a part of our learning process.
Exodium has been curating amazing tests that are very holistic in nature and have actually helped us a lot in analyzing our preparation for the competitive exams.
Reading and researching have always been my things, but Exodium helped me develop a habit to constantly think, analyze, and relate to what I read. Sometimes all you need is a push to set your thoughts in motion. Exodium was that push to my thoughts.
Exodium gave me a spiffing opportunity of interviewing IAS Prashant Nair. It was an exuberant session which just did not help the aspirants, but the volunteers as well. To sum up my experience,
hello.
Hi guys, Exodium is a society that provides you a proper guidance how to crack a civil service exam such as UPSC and SSC. Not that they provide right guidance for it, because we all know to crack these exams we need a proper guidance, not just coaching, a smart way. And Exodium is all about that.
I have been a member of Exodium since past 10 months now. It has helped me in brushing up my graphic designing skills and enhanced my personality by making me a meticulous planner.
Preparing for civil services is an extremely stressful affair. But in Exordium, all fellow aspirants help each other learn and grow. Exordium has immense potential and
one of open team of Exordium. So basically मुझे document team में आकर के बहुत ज़्यादा help हुई है. मुझे कहाँ से preparation अपनी start करनी है, कहाँ से क्या content चाहिए, मुझे इस सब की काफ़ी अच्छे से और एक teamwork capability भी मेरी बड़ी है. So thank you so much Exordium.
One thing that I've learned from it is that it is really important for us to maintain one book set and not to change it every day. It is better to read one book 10 times rather than reading 10 different books only once. And also to keep up with the routine that we have fixed for ourselves. That will help.
I was fortunate enough to interview Colonel Satyendra Verma for our Inspirigence Volume 2 Live series. Peace and motivation.
I have been the part of Exordium since the beginning of it. Exordium has placed me with a group of people who are equally motivated to achieve their goals, but at the same time, it maintains that we are here to learn collectively.
Exordium has taught me the value of social media in transmitting neutral and quality information. Just like Inspirigence, where we talk to eminent personalities about their life journey and learn a lot from them.
Exordium is touching heights with unexpected speed, and with all the skills and experience, it will become one of the best society among these.
Public Relations Department, Exordium, provided me a platform to share my thoughts, beliefs and concerns with the diplomats of our nation, and various channels of the cell helped me to embrace the diplomatic behavior and enhance my communication skills.
So, आपने experience देख लिया होगा बच्चों का सबने. So, देखो इसमें I know कि काफी लोगों के चेहरे पे smile नहीं है, मतलब काफी होता है ना कंफ्यूज इमोशन है उसमें. उसमें गलती उनकी नहीं है. इट वॉज नॉट देयर फॉल्ट बिकॉज एक ओवर एक्साइटमेंट है संजीव सर को सुनने का. एंड क्योंकि वो हमारे एक तरीके से मोरल है, इतना कुछ उनने करा मतलब होता है ना कि एक इंसान इतना कुछ करके बैठा है कि मतलब बोलने के लिए वर्ड ही नहीं हमारे पास. सो फॉर दैट रीजन जब हम लोग बना रहे थे इस वीडियो को एंड जब सर ने हाँ कर दिया तो हम इतने ज्यादा एक्साइटेड हो चुके थे कि हमको सब हम वेट ही नहीं कर पा रहे थे. मतलब हम हमारे काम वाइंड अप कर पा रहे थे नहीं कर पा रहे थे, बट फिर भी हम चाह रहे थे कि डेट जल्दी आए क्योंकि संजीव सर को सुनना है. तो इसलिए मैं सोचता हूँ कि मेरे को जो लगता है कि इसमें इनमें से किसी की भी गलती नहीं है अगर थोड़े कंफ्यूज इमोशन दिखे हो तो, बिकॉज वो ओवर एक्साइटमेंट है जो चेहरे पर कुछ ज्यादा ही झलक रहा है. इतने कन्फ्यूज इमोशन फेस पर ला रहा है कि किसी का फॉल्ट नहीं है. एंड लास्ट लाइन जो मैं बोलना चाहूंगा, एज यू नो हेनरी फोर्ड द ऑनर ऑफ फोर्ड इंडस्ट्री से, Anyone who stops learning is old. Anyone who stops learning is old, whether at the age of 20 or whether at the age of 80. Anyone who keeps learning stay young and strong. The great thing in the life is to stay young instead of getting old. And that's why that is in our hand, by learning or not. So that's all from my side. So I would like to welcome Ms. Vartika Mathur, our convener, to say some words on behalf of college. Ma'am?
Yeah, thank you very much. It was an amazing video, very inspiring, by the way. And good evening, Mr. Chopra and your dynamic team, my respected colleagues who are also part of our inauguration today, and my dear students. At the outset, please accept my apologies on behalf of Venkat sir, our acting principal, because he had to step out of office for an urgent work, so he cannot be here. So, but then show must go on. Mr. Chopra, it's an absolute honor to have you with us in the inauguration of the first academic year of Exordium, Civil Service Cells of Sri Venkateshwara College. And frankly, I have never tried to study for civil services, and I was a little apprehensive when Shiva approached me for conveniership, but looking at these students' dynamism and how enthusiastically they've been working all through the COVID, so it really inspired me, and I thought, okay, maybe I'll also learn something from this, and by all the words that I'm going to listen to from all the experts here. Sir, Exordium was actually founded by this team of very enthusiastic students, Shivam and Jay, Ritika, Shreyas, many students together in March 2020, right before the COVID lockdown. And this was actually formed to guide and counsel undergraduate students who are preparing for civil services. But even this unfortunate scenario of lockdown did not dampen their spirit. And instead, this dynamic team found ways to connect with students while coping with their own studies. The college was regularly going on, and still these people, these students beautifully managed both the things together. And of diverse subjects, Exordium has organized a monthly quiz on their Instagram handle based on important themes such as oil crisis, fundamental rights, POXO Act. Moreover, an online live Instagram series, as Shivam already mentioned, Inspirations was organized from 11th to 21 June 2020, consisting of sessions by various bureaucrats and IAS toppers who gave tips and tricks for cracking civil services. So besides, students were also engaged in newspaper analysis for keeping abreast with the current affairs. So this, and also they've formed small study groups and to teach them soft skills such as time management, teamwork, decisiveness, personality development. And all of these qualities are being fostered by Exordium for these students. So when our students become successful, it's the institution that grows with them. And with our society, we want to see more and more of our students reaching that pinnacle in their careers. So I encourage all the students who are preparing for civil services or who are even considering that as an option for later to join us and be an icon like Mr. Chopra. So thank you very much. Shivam, over to you.
Rajdeep. So now Rajdeep will come and he will give a small introduction about Sanjeev sir. So I will invite Rajdeep. Can you please continue?
Okay. Good evening, everyone. My name is Rajdeep. It is a great honor for me to introduce and welcome our chief guest this evening, Mr. Sanjeev Chopra. Starting his career as an intern journalist to an IAS officer of 1985 batch, he is truly an inspiration for all of us. He was born in Kapurthala district of Punjab, and prior to his career, he also served as additional chief secretary and agricultural production commissioner of West Bengal. He is currently the director of Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration, Mussoorie. Labasna shoulders the crucial responsibility to train the civil servants of the country. Apart from serving in various administrative domains, he is also the principal patron to a key literacy festival, the Valley of Words, which is celebrated in Dehradun every single year. As the motto of Labasna suggests, Shilam Param Bhushadam, which means character is the prime virtue, and it is truly reflected in our guest speaker. I welcome you, sir, on the behalf of the whole Exordium team, and I request you to please enlighten us with your kind words. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Rajdeep. Thank you, Dr. Vartika Mathur. And thank you very much, Shivam, for organizing this. And I have with me five young officers who've just cracked the civil services exam. So I thought, while I will speak to you for about 5 to 10 minutes, they can share with you and you will be freer to talk to them because they are the ones who've taken the exam very recently. And they are the ones who are more in touch with the current phase of UPSC preparation, because you see, UPSC morphs itself every 5 years. So the system of examination that was being followed in 1979 was changed by the time we were taking the exam. That got changed in 1990, then it again got changed. So these young officers, they have a much better idea of how to crack the current UPSC exam. But just to put things in perspective, I think there were three or four main ways in which the exam has been looked at. You see, before the advent of the photocopier, and the photocopier became ubiquitous around the early 80s. So before the 1980s, everybody had to go to the library and make notes to take this examination. And that meant that, you had to go back to original sources. You had to go to some encyclopedia, you had to go to hard textbooks, to make the notes for the UPSC. By the time we took the exam, I was in JNU at that time. And so a lot of photocopying had started. So we were able to make use of the notes of our senior colleagues. And so preparing for the exam became slightly easier. But to some extent, it also lost that charm of going and making your own unique note. So I think the examiners in 1980s would have found every examination, you know, every answer to be very different from the other answer, because everybody would have made different notes, and certainly the notes made in the Calcutta library would have been different from the notes made in JNU, would have been different from the notes made in Chandigarh, would have been different from the notes made in Kanpur, because you would have had different sets of materials and people would have looked at things differently. The photocopying changed all that. So that made, I mean, also that shows how the numbers of people taking the exam, started increasing, because till the 80s, I think it would not have been possible for somebody in Gorakhpur or for somebody in Nawanshahr or for somebody in Mokokchung to take the exam, because those libraries would just not have been available, because you could not have had the possibility of preparing your notes in, say, philosophy or anthropology or any other subject if you were not in a university system or in a college which was very well established, or you had colleagues or contacts which had just taken the exam. So that changed after 1980s, because photocopying became the norm, and I think people made a lot of money near JNU and in old Kamla Nagar. You know, the photocopying machines, they made a lot of money because they would just, you know, cyclostyle notes and give those notes. Then around the mid-90s, I think the competition master and the CSR and the Bajiram and Rao and the Rao's IAS study circle, I mean, they became really very, very important players. In fact, I think amongst those who have made the most money in the country are those who prepare others to sit for the civil services exam. Because I think Vajiram and Rao's IAS study circle, they made more money than the collective salary of IAS officers in the country in any given year. Because collectively, the total salary of 6,000 IAS officers would amount to 6,000 into maybe 1.5 lakhs on an average. But given the fact that the number of people who sit for the exam isn't many more, so these people, they make more money than all the IAS officers put together in one year. So it's a good business model which they have, but then there are problems with this business model. The problem with this business model is that, one, it does not give what it says it will give, right? So it is a big, I can't use the word racket for it, but it is somewhere between, somewhere between a racket and what should you call it? I mean, somewhere in between. So, you know, people crack this exam, 2-3 things are very important. One, you cannot crack this exam unless you work hard. You have to work very, very hard and extremely hard. And there are no second guesses about it. You know, if there are so many people competing for the exam. Now, the point is that, is the material that you need for the exam exclusively available in these institutes, or is it available in general and it has only been hyped up beyond a point? You know, sometimes what happens is, and that's a general statement I wish to make, sometimes the hype is so much that we even tend to forget what is good for us and what is not good for us. One of the most stressed things which I've seen is, you know, that when you find laborers and workers, you know, taking home, you know, tonic, you know, cough syrup or this or that, or buying things. That sort of energy is available through eggs, it's available through bananas, it's available through milk. I mean, these sources are there, but the market has hyped up some of these special, chyavanprash or this or Dabur honey or whatever. I mean, they made it, hyped it up so much, which is not, it is not in sync with what is being said. So that's the problem here. The problem here is that, so I'm glad that young people in colleges in Delhi have started understanding and thinking that the only way you study and the only way you prepare is through a process of collaboration. And while this examination is certainly an examination in which you compete with each other, but the basis of this competition has to be collaboration and working together. Because, as has been said, and I like that one statement which is made, that it is better to read the same book 10 times rather than read 10 books superficially. So I like that statement. I like that comment. And I'm glad that we are learning to work together, because the more democratic this exam becomes, the more people who take this exam, because one thing is for sure, that look, everybody will not be able to succeed in this exam. But the preparation for this exam is itself a charm, it's an end, it's a beauty, and it's a pleasurable thing in itself. So let's make this experience pleasurable. Let's make this experience stress-free. Let's also tell everyone that whoever has cracked this exam, there is an element of hard work, there's an element of luck, there's an element of blessing, and there's an element of chance. So all these things together, go in to make a civil servant, get him to clear the civil service exam. And as I've been telling them, and I've been telling every batch, that no one who says that he has cracked the exam without being tense is speaking off his hat. That is why 4 days before the exam, I had written down in my diary that at any point of time, if I become arrogant, that I was always very confident, let me record how nervous I feel today. That was on 2nd of June, 1985. The exam result came out on the 5th of June. So immediately after the exam, you all get very confident. Oh, hona hi tha, ye ho gaya, wo ho gaya. But let me tell you that everybody, I have not yet seen a person who has said that he was... Because this exam is different. It's not like writing the BSc exam, or it's not like writing the BA honors exam in English, or writing the LLB exam, where if you've done well, you will crack. Here, the competition is not a question of passing an exam. It's a question of, so you know all these things. Let me stop here and let me request all those who have just cleared the exam to speak for 1 or 2 minutes. And they can inspire, and they can give their experiences, and they can also, to my mind, let everybody know that you do not have to be critically dependent on any external coaching agency. You need material. That material is easily available. That material can be shared. And you must have this tradition of colleges and universities and groups of friends, which now become families, preparing together for this exam. And not only that, being of support to each other if somebody does not crack it. Because that is also very important. Because let us also remember that more people will not clear the exam than will clear the exam, right? So you also need a support system. You also need a system where you understand that it is not necessary that, you cannot crack this exam unless you have worked hard. But let us also understand that even if we work very hard, we may not crack this exam. So it is a little degree of balance and we need to support each other in this process. But certainly writing this exam also gives you such an idea about India, which normally you would not be able to get. It's like a journey. It's like a lovely travelogue. It's a journey with oneself. It's a dialogue with oneself. So I'm very glad that you've taken this initiative. Congratulations, Shivam. Congratulations, Dr. Vartika Mathur. Congratulations, Pradeep and Rajdeep. Is it Rajdeep? Right, Rajdeep. And so, thank you very much. And may I, with your permission, request all my young colleagues.
Quote for you. So basically, I have a quote for you. मतलब जो मैंने खाली आपके लिए ढूंढा था कि experience is not what happened to you. Experience is not what happened to you. It is what you do with what happened to you. It is said by Aldous Huxley. And ये आप पे बहुत ज्यादा सूट बैठता है क्योंकि आपने मतलब बेसिकली एक्सपीरियंस के बेसिस पे इतना ज्यादा हम लोगों को गाइड कर सकते हैं. इस वजह से मैं इतने ज्यादा एक्साइटेड था आपको सुनने के लिए. आपको सुनने के बाद इतना अच्छा लग रहा है कि मैंने मेरे को पहले से पता था कि ऐसा होने वाला है, इसलिए मैंने कोट आपने स्पेशली ढूंढ के रखा.
थोड़ा ज्यादा हो रहा है. अभी तुम यहाँ ट्रेनिंग में नहीं आए हो, और वैसे भी तुम्हें बता दूं कि डायरेक्टर्स असेसमेंट डायरेक्टर के हाथ में नहीं होती है. डायरेक्टर्स असेसमेंट जो कोर्स कोऑर्डिनेटर बोल देते हैं उसको साइन कर देते हैं. थैंक यू वेरी मच. थैंक यू शिवम. चलो, यस बिश्नोई.
So, sir has rightly pointed out that this examination is very, very dynamic. And it's so because of the dynamism that is involved in this examination, it becomes very confusing and uncertain in the beginning. So if I tell you about my experience, so I graduated in 2016, but right from the first year of my college, I wanted to be a civil servant and crack this examination. But unfortunately, back then, I was very confused and I did not know where to start. And we did not have the right kind of guidance at the level of college. So right after my college, I found myself, you know, very, very, because suddenly the pressure came. So right now, when you are in college and if these initiatives are there, I think this is the best time and the best way to start because the pressure is not there. You know, when you'll graduate and when you'll actually write the exam, you'll stop enjoying the process. And right, and this examination is more about holistic personality development. And, you know, that can happen right now. The collaboration can happen right now because the year that you'll be actually writing the examination, then you'll just have to, you know, mug up things and read newspapers. And then there will be not a space for this. And I think if I would have had this opportunity back then in my time, I guess it would have taken me lesser time to come here and to clear this examination. But nonetheless, I would tell you that make the best use of this time. Okay. And this will fetch you, you know, very high returns when you actually write the examination. Secondly, I would want to tell you about this initiative that the 2020 batch of the civil services examination, the civil servants have started, all 428 of us. So they have started a page called csewiki.com, and there we have clubbed in the strategies of most of the toppers, be it of the subject toppers or, you know, GS specific. So the biggest, according to me, the one of the biggest problem that we usually face is the direction, you know, what to study, where to study. And if you have that consolidated at one place, I think that will give you a very nice push from the beginning. So that is what we have done. We've like all of us have consulted and we have, you know, given a consolidated book list, and then subject wise strategies have also been provided. There's some people in our batch who also keep taking regular classes on YouTube and, you know, sharing topper strategies. Personally, I have benefited a lot from topper strategies. For the past 2 years, I've also prepared, you know, from a very, very remote place where there was only internet connection and no physical coaching as such. And as sir is saying that, you know, the technique of preparation and the examination is changing, and now is the time of internet. And we are very lucky that that has really democratized the process of preparation. And we should harness it to the maximum extent possible, you know. I think I benefited a lot from it, you know, from what the toppers were saying and how they were doing. So I strongly believe that we do not need to depend on the traditional physical coaching at all. We can go our own way of understanding this examination, going through the past year's, you know, question papers and the consolidated book list, and ultimately hard work is what will sail you through.
Good, very good. Chalo.
I think Pari has almost covered most of the points. One point that the sir was saying, I would also like to emphasize, is about collaboration. I mean, it took me 3 attempts to clear the exams, and I would say I also took the coaching and I realized the pros and cons of that thing. I mean, initially when I was new to this thing, then I thought that okay, the coaching thing will sail me through the examination. But after the first attempt, I realized that it is fine. They are helping us to correct some of the concept, but mostly it's about rote learning is also going on there. So when I was fortunate to have a group of 5 to 6 people, we studied together, we analyzed the previous year's paper. I think that is one of the most important element that is missed in this preparation. So whether if you go through prelims or the mains examination or essay paper, if you try to understand what the UPSC is asking for, it is asking for conceptual understanding, a depth in understanding. It's not about like you just have done the some newspaper analysis and mugged up the facts and reproduce it. That is not there. So if we have a collaborative study team, then we can analyze the paper, strengthen our conceptual understanding. And when we have basic understanding about all the topics, then I mean, whatever kind of question paper is there, whether topic is simple or difficult, you would be able to write good content on it. And one more thing I would like to say is about in UPSC, it's about knowledge as well as expression. Because most of the time student tends to accumulate knowledge. I mean, read several books and try to have too many things. But, you know, in the answer, we have only 5 to 7 minutes per answer. In that answer, believe me, we after we prepare for 1 or 2 years, we have sufficient knowledge. How to express it, how to make it easy for an examiner to understand, these are also the skills that we need to cultivate within ourselves to clear this exam.
Nahi, bahut theek bola hai. Chaliye, ab bhi batayiye.
गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन. और अभी जैसा कि परी और आशीष दोनों ने काफी कुछ बता दिया है इस प्रिपरेशन के बारे में, तो मैं बहुत ज्यादा कुछ नहीं बोलूंगा, बस एक चीज बताऊंगा कि तीन चीजें इस एग्जाम के लिए बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट हैं। पहली चीज जो अगर हम देखें तो सर ने भी बोला कि हार्ड वर्क एंड कंसिस्टेंसी। इट्स नॉट ओनली कि आप हार्ड वर्क किए जा रहे हो और आप एक दिन पढ़ते हो, हफ्ते में चार दिन पढ़ते हो और बाकी के दो दिन आप नहीं पढ़ते हो, तो कंसिस्टेंसी वो चीज है जो कि यूपीएससी में बहुत ज्यादा मैटर करती है। अगर आपको चार घंटे ही पढ़ाई करनी है तो चार ही घंटे करो, बट आपको हफ्ते के सारे दिन आपको पढ़ाई करनी होगी। और दूसरी चीज जो होती है वो ये है कि यूपीएससी सिलेबस सारे, मैंने शुरुआत में मैंने ये लकली मेरा फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट था और शुरुआत के मैंने दो महीने कोचिंग भी ली थी, लेकिन फॉर्चुनेटली मैंने कोचिंग सही टाइम पे डिसीजन लेके मैंने कोचिंग छोड़ के सेल्फ स्टडी पे ही फोकस किया। और उसमें जो सबसे अच्छी चीज मैंने की थी कि सबसे पहले मैंने यूपीएससी सिलेबस देखा, चाहे वो प्रीलिम्स हो और खासकर मेंस के जो सिलेबस में एक एक वर्ड जो दिए हुए हैं, यू हैव टू बी रियली उससे आपको स्टिक करना होगा और अपनी प्रिपरेशन को। लोग कहते हैं कि इन यूपीएससी एवरीथिंग अंडर सन यू हैव टू मग अप एंड यू हैव टू नो, बट मुझे लगता है कि ये चीज बहुत ही एक मिथ है कि आपको हर चीज जानना है। आपको अपनी प्रिपरेशन यूपीएससी सिलेबस से ही ले जानी होगी और उसी के अराउंड आपको स्टिक रहना पड़ेगा, चाहे वो न्यूज़पेपर हो चाहे एनीथिंग, यू हैव टू बी अराउंड द यूपीएससी सिलेबस ओनली। अगर दूसरी चीज जो आशीष ने भी बोला कि यू हैव टू एनालाइज प्रीवियस जो पेपर्स हैं उसको भी एनालाइज करना होगा। अगर आप लास्ट ईयर 2019 का पेपर भी देखोगे तो ईच एंड एवरी क्वेश्चन वो यूपीएससी के सिलेबस से ही आया हुआ था, और ना कि बहुत ज्यादा करंट अफेयर को भी उन्होंने फोकस नहीं किया था, रादर कि उन्होंने सारे क्वेश्चन यूपीएससी सिलेबस से ही ड्राफ्ट किए थे। तो मैं यही कहूंगा कि यूपीएससी सिलेबस से आपको पूरी तरह से स्टिक करना होगा। और तीसरी चीज है राइट गाइडेंस, तो राइट गाइडेंस वो कहीं से भी मिल सकती है, आपका एक प्रेरणा स्रोत होना चाहिए, चाहे वो आपका दोस्त हो, चाहे प्रीवियस ईयर के कोई टॉपर्स हो जो जिन्होंने ये एग्जाम क्रैक किया हो, इवन आपके पेरेंट्स भी आपके वो राइट गाइडेंस दे सकते हैं। ये भी एक मिथ है कि कोचिंग जब तक आप नहीं करोगे तो ही आपका सिलेक्शन होगा, और जैसा कि परी ने भी बताया कि पेपर काफी डायनेमिक है, पेपर सिलेबस और क्वेश्चंस हमेशा चेंज, नॉट सिलेबस, क्वेश्चंस के पैटर्न हमेशा चेंज होते रह रहे हैं, तो उस समय कोचिंग्स भी इररिलेवेंट होते जा रहे हैं इस समय में। तो इस समय हमें यही देखना होगा कि क्वेश्चन पेपर को आप एनालाइज करो, यूपीएससी प्रिपरेशन को, यूपीएससी सिलेबस को देखो, प्लस राइट डायरेक्शन में आपको इंटरनेट का भी पूरी तरीके से यूज करना है कि आप कितने मिनिमम इनपुट में मैक्सिमम आप गेन कर सकते हो इंटरनेट के थ्रू, ताकि आपका समय बच सके कोचिंग में जाने के लिए। तो ये तीन चीज मैं कहूंगा कि ये बहुत ही ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है। और आगे जहां तक बात है कि हमारी भी टीम यहाँ से कोलैबोरेट करना चाहेगी आप लोगों से, और हम लोग भी जितना हो सकता है यूपीएससी से रिलेटेड चीजों को, चाहे वो नोट्स हो, चाहे हमारी तरफ से मोटिवेशनल चीजें हो, या कोई भी किसी चीज पे स्पेशल लेक्चर जिसपे आपको लगता हो कि हम लोग आपको मदद कर सकते हैं, हम पूरी कोशिश करेंगे कि हम यहाँ से समय निकाल के आप मदद करें बच्चों की।
थैंक यू, वेरी गुड।
गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। एज दे हैव राइटली पुट मेनी ऑफ द पॉइंट्स व्हिच आर क्रूशियल फॉर द यूपीएससी प्रिपरेशन, आई वुड लाइक टू ऐड जस्ट टू पॉइंट्स। One is the fact that you need to do repetitive revisions, because that's the point where many of us lag sometimes. We think that if we take new information, that would be much more value addition to our previous knowledge bank. But if you don't do the repetitive revisions, then effectively when the time is short in the exam, you won't be able to reproduce the same. So one point that you need to keep in mind is to have repetitive revisions, even if it is for a fact, for a statement or a particular quote. And the second aspect I would like to stress upon is that never self-doubt yourself. Be confident, do some regular exercises, yoga, so that you can relieve some stress and you could do the best that you could do in your exam and don't have any regrets about it. So with that, I'll conclude and wish you all the best for your initiatives.
Very good.
मैंने ये एग्जाम सिक्स्थ अटेम्प्ट में क्लियर किया है, तो मैंने इसमें छह बार अपना प्रीलिम्स भी क्लियर किया और मेंस दिया, तो मेरे को काफी वाइड मैंने देखा कि चेंज होते हुए यूपीएससी का ट्रेंड्स, और साथ में अपने ही भी डिफरेंट तरीके से अपने को तैयार किया, जैसे कभी शुरू में कोचिंग से और उसके बाद में सेल्फ स्टडी से। तो मेरा एक्सपीरियंस ये रहा कि अगर आपको आप जैसे टॉपर्स की इंटरव्यूज हैं या कोई सही गाइड मिल जाए आपको जो पर्सनली आपको मेंटर करे, तो उससे ज़्यादा फायदा होता है एज कम्पेयर टू कोचिंग. और साथ में मैंने ये देखा है कि जैसे आंसर राइटिंग के ऊपर हमें ज्यादा फोकस रखना चाहिए इसमें ओवरऑल, एंड कंसिस्टेंटली जैसे इसने भी कहा कि हमें जो कुछ एरियाज है उनको रिपीटेटिवली भी करना पड़ेगा. और जैसे 5 से 7 मिनट हैं आशीष ने अभी बताया था जैसे कि एक क्वेश्चन को पूरा करने के लिए, तो उसमें हमें अपने आप को इस तरह से पूरी तरह से तैयार करना है कि हम उसको अच्छे से इंट्रोडक्शन दे के क्वेश्चन का उसको अच्छे से एंड करके जो रेलिवेंट चीजें हैं उसमें ऐड कर सकें. और साथ में ये पूरा प्रोसेस ऐसा है कि हमें काफी पेशेंस रखनी पड़ती है और अपने आप को अपने मेंटल कंट्रोल रखना पड़ता है पेपर में भी और पेपर की से पहले भी. तो इसलिए हमें योगा आदि या स्पिरिचुअलिटी इन सब चीजों का की मदद लेने में कोई संकोच नहीं करना चाहिए. तो मेरा तो ये एक्सपीरियंस रहा है.
बहुत बढ़िया. तो देखिए कितने वेरिड एक्सपीरियंसेस हैं यहाँ पे. दिस इटसेल्फ इज अ वेरी लर्निंग एक्सपीरियंस. फाइनली आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ अस हैव एग्रीड कि इट इज नॉट हाउ मच यू नो, इट इज हाउ मच यू कैन राइट इन दैट लिमिटेड टाइम. आपके पास पूरा इंफॉर्मेशन होने के पूरा संविधान आप पढ़ लीजिए, लेकिन अगर संविधान पे टिप्पणी करनी है, अगर संविधान के किसी एक अनुच्छेद पे टिप्पणी करनी है, तो आपके पास 5 मिनट से ज्यादा नहीं. इसलिए क्योंकि मैं पहले जर्नलिस्ट था, इसलिए मुझे ये एक्सपीरियंस था कि बड़ी बात को इतने मटेरियल को कैसे कंसाइज करना है या कैसे छोटे मटेरियल को और बड़ा करना. तो मैं जो एक सबसे जो मैं जनरल गाइडेंस देता हूँ यही है कि कोई भी एक सब्जेक्ट लीजिए, जैसे अभी फार्मर्स एजिटेशन चल रहा है या कोई भी अभी ट्रंप का दे ले लीजिए, कुछ भी ले लीजिए. द सब्जेक्ट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, बट वॉट यू हैव टू डू इज यू हैव टू राइट द सेम थिंग इन 200 वर्ड्स, इन 500 वर्ड्स एंड इन 1000 वर्ड्स एंड टाइम योरसेल्फ, बिकॉज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज टाइमिंग. यू आर नॉट लुकिंग फॉर द परफेक्ट आंसर, यू आर लुकिंग फॉर द राइट आंसर इन दैट लिमिटेड टाइम. क्योंकि अगर दुनिया में हर एक आदमी के पास इनफाइनाइट समय हो तो ये काम नहीं चल सकता. चैलेंज यही है हम सबके सामने कि स्वार्थ. मैं गारंटी के साथ कह सकता हूं कि बहुत लोगों को हमसे कहीं ज्यादा सूचना उस समय थी उनके दिमाग में जब उन्होंने एग्जाम दिया. जिन लोगों से मैंने फोटोकॉपिंग ली उनमें से बहुत कम लोग ही सिविल सर्वेंट्स हो पाए, बट क्योंकि जो तजर्बा है राइटिंग का, यू हैव टू राइट एंड राइट एवरी डे. सो अगर आप, मेरा जो एडिशनल पॉइंट होगा या इन्होंने भी कहा है, अगर आप 4 घंटे पढ़ रहे हो तो कम से कम 2-3 घंटे लिखो. और हर रोज जब तक आप नहीं लिखोगे, आपकी जब तक प्रैक्टिस नहीं होगी, आपको सडनली ये लगे कि आप यूपीएससी वाले दिन ही आप अपनी अंग्रेजी या हिंदी या जो भी भाषा है उसमें आप फटाफट लिख देंगे तो नहीं हो पाएगा. इट इज अ कंटिन्यूअस प्रैक्टिस, इट इज अ स्किल. राइटिंग एंड एग्जामिनेशन इज अ स्किल, इट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम नॉलेज. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड दैट वेरी क्लियरली. The one message that I think all of us would like to give to you, and I think all of us are agreed,
yes,
more than knowledge, it is the skill to write in brief, in the time limit that has been given to you. Aur agar aapko 5 minute ka 10 number ka sawal hai, us pe aap agar aadha ghanta likh rahe hain, to bewakoofi hai wo. Because you are going to be graded not on, you are to be graded on each answer. And if there is a maximum mark of 10 marks on that answer, you can only put efforts of 10 marks in that answer. So that is what we like to share with you. And this is a very practical suggestion that you have to do in a week or a fortnight, you can do a Zoom call in which the aspirants are directly our new officer trainees will be in touch with them. और जो बिश्नोई ने जो वेबसाइट बताई है, जो भी आपने उसके बारे में भी जानकारी लें. एंड शिवम, वेरी गुड दैट यू टेकन दिस इनिशिएटिव, सो थैंक यू. इट विल बी एन ऑनगोइंग डायलॉग. ये तो नहीं है कि एक दिन के डायलॉग में सब चीजें सॉल्व हो जाएंगी, ये कंटिन्यूइंग डायलॉग है. और ये डायलॉग, मैं बहुत खुश हूँ कि मेरे यंग कोलीग्स ने भी इस पे, इनफैक्ट जिस दिन आपसे बात हुई थी शिवम, उसी दिन इनसे भी बात हो गई थी. तो ये हम चाहते हैं कि ये जो मिथ है जो प्रिपरेशन के बारे में जो मिथक है, ये हम चीज बड़ा क्लियरली करना चाहते हैं कि जस्ट बिकॉज समबडी हैज मनी ही डज नॉट गिव हिम एन एक्स्ट्रा माइल. क्योंकि किसी के पास 2 लाख रुपए है एग्जामिनेशन में खर्च करने के लिए, वो ऐसा उसको कोई बहुत ज्यादा कंपेटिटिव एडवांटेज नहीं है. 2000 रुपए में भी हम ये एग्जाम और बिना पैसे के भी हम ये मटीरियल उपलब्ध कराने की पूरी कोशिश करेंगे. क्योंकि हमारा यह मानना है कि दिस एग्जाम इज अ डेमोक्रेटिक एग्जाम, दिस एग्जाम इज स्ट्रेंथनिंग दिस कंट्री. अगर ये देश चल रहा है तो ये देश ब्यूरोक्रेसी का एक बहुत अहम रोल है इस देश में, और जिस तरीके से सरदार पटेल ने 311 आर्टिकल 311 पहला संविधान है दुनिया में जिसने सिविल सर्वेंट्स को इतना सशक्त किया, और हमारी जिम्मेवारी है, हमारी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है, हमारी ड्यूटी है कि हम अपने देश के लिए अच्छे से अच्छा जो भी हम कर सकें हमें करना चाहिए। थैंक यू शिवम फॉर गिविंग अस दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी।
थैंक यू सो मच सर। अगर किसी को कोई क्वेश्चन पूछना है तो आप होस्टों को टेक्स्ट कर सकते हो, सो हम अगर मतलब किसी भी गेस्ट से अगर कोई भी क्वेश्चन पूछना है तो हम क्या है वो रिजर्व कर लेंगे, सो इफ एनीवन हैज एनी क्वेश्चन देन दे कैन टेक्स्ट टू एनी होस्ट।
होस्ट ऑफ होस्ट गिव इन द चैट बॉक्स और प्रोबब्ली ईमेल शिवम दैट वेबसाइट दैट व्हिच यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट।
मैम मैं भी थोड़ी देर बाद मतलब आफ्टर दिस मीटिंग में एक बार सर से वापस बात करके सबको सारी डिटेल रिटर्न में
आप डील करेंगे।
हां मैम
तो डॉक्टर साहब जो हैं डॉक्टर धीरज ना, डॉक्टर धीरज विल बी योर कांटेक्ट पर्सन, ही इज द नोडल ऑफिसर फ्रॉम द फॉर द सोसाइटी फॉर सोशल सर्विसेज, सो ही विल बी इन डायरेक्ट टच विद यू एंड ही विल बोथ ऑफ यू विल कैरी द डायलॉग फॉरवर्ड, एंड आपके जितने भी फ्रेंड्स पार्टिसिपेट करना चाहें दे आर मोस्ट वेलकम। हमारे यहाँ से भी हमारे इस करंट फेज वन के उससे पहले जो एफसी वाले हैं वो भी, और बहुत सारी मिसकंसेप्शन है लोगों के मन में। मैं भी लक्षद्वीप में था, वहां पे कुछ लड़कियां कहने लगी कि हम डेनिक्स की तैयारी कर रहे हैं, और मैं कहा डेनिक्स की तैयारी क्या होती है, कोई डेनिक्स की भी तैयारी होती है या कोई मतलब वो मतलब कोई इतना ज्यादा मिसकंसेप्शन है बहुत रिमोट एरियाज में, तो वी हैव टू रिमूव ऑल दीज मिसकंसेप्शन राइट, and we will certainly work with you right। theek hai ab apna mobile number bol dijiye inko
bata diye dheeraj, it will be fun to work especially talk to you and I'm directly in contact with AIIMS, so I'm an advisor to All India Institute also, so you will also have old memories matlab tumhare doctor wali memories bhi we keep discussing
तो डॉक्टर साहब आप भी एग्जाम दे दीजिए, ऐसी क्या बात है
सर अब तो वो डायरेक्ट वो आजकल वो एकेडमिशन वाला है ना, आई विल प्रोबब्ली लुक फॉर दैट, अब तो
लेटरल एंट्री वो ज्यादा कामयाब भी होने वाली है ये लेटरल
एंट्री। सर आई हैव क्रॉस द स्टेज वेयर आई एम ऑलरेडी 16 इयर्स ऑफ सर्विस, आई एम नाउ एट प्रोफेसर ग्रेड, सो वो तो खत्म हो गया सर मेरा अपॉर्चुनिटी।
चलिए कोई बात नहीं, कोई बात नहीं, तो लेटरल एंट्री के लिए अगर आप आएंगे तो ठीक है, लेट अस सी। चलिए थैंक यू वेरी मच, थैंक यू सो मच, ओके राइट बाय।
सर एक स्टूडेंट ने पूछा है कि पॉलिटी मतलब पॉलिटी और कुछ करंट अफेयर्स के जो नोट्स होते हैं वो 2-3 साल के बाद भी काम के होते हैं।
आई थिंक वो आई थिंक ही इज लेफ्ट
ओके
सो
एनीवे यू कैन मिस लाइक कम्युनिकेट
अनन्य,
आई थिंक यू कैन कलेक्ट द ऑल द क्वेश्चंस एंड कम्युनिकेट विद हिम।
हां आई विल श्योरली
एंड टेक धीरज नंबर
अनन्य वोट ऑफ थैंक्स के लिए आप प्रोसीड करें।
आई थिंक ही दे वर बिजी सो डजंट मैटर, सो जस्ट थैंक मे बी यू कैन थैंक द पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड ऑल द टीचर्स।
या श्योर मैम, आफ्टर दिस अस्टाउंडिंग इनॉग्रेशन सेशन होस्टेड बाय आवर फाउंडर मिस्टर शिवम गणेशिया, आई वुड लाइक टू टेक दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द एंटायर एक्सोडियम सेल टू एक्सटेंड अ वोट ऑफ थैंक्स टू आवर गेस्ट ऑफ ऑनर फॉर टुडेज इवनिंग व्हिच which is Mr. Dr. Sanjeev Chopra, Director of Labasna, and all the young officers for taking out their valuable time and inspiring our youth. It has been an honor to have you. Further, I would like to thank our principal, Mr. Venkat Kumar, for his continuous support and encouragement, without which Exodium would not have been at the position it is right now. We are truly grateful to you, sir. Moving on, I would take this opportunity to thank all the heads of different departments, teachers, respected societies of our college, and the entire audience for joining us in our celebration and motivating us for achieving new heights. I would like to extend my thanks to our convener, Dr. Vartika Mathur, for providing us with her continuous assistance. Last but not the least, I would extend my heartfelt thanks to the entire team of Exodium, who have put remarkable efforts in making this event a huge success. It would not have been possible without the hard work of each one of you. Once again, I would like to say that we are truly grateful to our entire audience and speakers present on this forum. We thank you for this evening, and it is a pleasure having you all. Thank you very much.
And from my end, I would like to thank the whole team for organizing this inauguration very well. My also big thanks to Dr. Rajinder Pratyar for coordinating this whole event. Thank you so much, Rajinder. And to Dr. Kameshwar Sharma, who could give us this Zoom platform where we could very easily and conveniently do this. So thank you, Department of Biochemistry, for giving us this Zoom platform. Thank you very much. Thanks, Rajinder.
So guys, abhi 5 minute ka break hai, then orientation session will start. So those who want to stay, then they can stay. So in orientation, basically you will go to know about society in detail.
I think the teachers can leave and you people can continue with the orientation, Shiva. Is that okay?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Okay, and one more thing. This thing is, it's like we are recording this thing. So it is recording on the cloud, okay? And once this thing is completely recorded, then it's like I will forward the recording to Vartika ma'am and any one of you. I think you also can download the recording. The co-hosts can also download the recordings, okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, so...
Hi Srishta and Ritika, you can take charge right now. So
okay, Shivam, a very good evening to one and all present here. We were elated to receive such an overwhelming response from you all, and we really feel honored to have you with us today evening. I can feel a lot of queries are running in your mind right now regarding Exordium. Like, what is this Exordium Society? Iski sari teams kya hai? What's the aim of Exordium? Iska registration process kya hai? How to join the society? And how the society is going to help you? Or why should you join the society? Oh, stop. And many more queries are running in your mind. But no worries. To solve all your queries, we are here with our orientation session. So we hope by the end of this session, आपकी ये सारी क्वेरीज क्लियर हो जाए एंड यू ऑल गेन अ गुड अमाउंट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग Exordium. इन केस ऑफ एनी डाउट्स प्लीज फील फ्री टू पुट देम फॉरवर्ड ड्यूरिंग द क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन दैट विल हैपन राइट आफ्टर द प्रेजेंटेशन एंड्स.
सो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज Exordium? Exordium is a student-driven civil services cell based in Sri Venkateshwara College. Set off by three determined students of our college in March 2020, the community has now grown to a number of more than 150 students, all of them who put in all their heart and soul at every step to finally bring laurels to this institute. All the members of Exordium engage in regular interactions with each other to hone their soft skills and gain a grip over the preparations of different fields of CSE. The same is attained through various events like online sessions, study group meetings, lecture series, and seminars, etc. Exordium aims at providing its members with a multitude of opportunities so that you all get to connect and learn from the experienced wise men. Here, we make sure each and every member has access to adequate resources in their process of learning and developing as an asset to the society. So let's talk about the teams that we have. Following are the teams, we have media and marketing team, public relations team, content team, logistics team, and a technical team. So let's start with the very first team, the core team. I'm sure all of you have been attending a lot of orientation sessions and might have come across terms like president, vice president, but what do they do? So the president, the first person to start off with, is the figurehead of the club. He takes the ultimate responsibility in essentially running the club. He chairs meetings and supports the work of other committee members. The president has a fair idea of who is doing what and keeps abreast of all club activities, as he is responsible for ensuring that the society works effectively. He provides leadership to the society and helps build an effective team that functions well and grows in membership while most importantly, remaining fun to be a part of. Next, we have the vice president. Now, this position is the backbone of the society and ensures that things run smoothly. Emails need to be written, rooms need to be booked, competitions need to be organized, and a lot of more things. For all of these, you can rely on your vice president. In the absence of the president, it is the vice president who takes care of the society. And then we have the general secretary. The secretary is generally responsible for the administration of the club, arranging meetings and taking down the minutes for when there might not be people there, and dealing with literally any administration regarding the club constitution. All correspondence will usually be handled by the secretary. The secretary ensures that the society's name is not spoiled, no matter what, and everything stays well in place. And then we have the treasurer. Might have guessed by the name, related to treasure. Yes, so this person is responsible to take care of the financial side of the society. He keeps all the records and accounts safely and hands them over to the president later. A treasurer's remit is to provide the society with sound financial administration so that all the aspects of the society's fund are properly managed and to be accounted for. And lastly, we have the central coordinator. The central coordinator is the head of the extended core. His main job, as the name says, is to coordinate with all the teams and take updates regularly, which are then passed to the main core. The different teams, the members among these teams must communicate with each other. And this is taken care of by the central coordinator. Exordium functions democratically. No position here overpower the others. And we ensure that we work like a family, where every point of view is respected and considered.
The next team of Exordium is media team. This idea of Exordium took roots in the period of lockdown. And how can anyone forget that beginning of COVID pandemic time? Lot of uncertainty, confusions, and nobody was having idea that when this situation will get better. So us time pe sabse pehli need thi ek unique approach lane ki, so that we could connect with college students and move forward in this pandemic time. So at that time, role of media team increased too much. And trust me, it wasn't that easy to connect with college students and have strong online presence. But our media team played a wonderful job and not only helped us in connecting with students of our college, but also with students from different universities who were in the need of proper guidance, who wants counseling. You might be thinking that what all this media team did, how it helped students. So a lot of initiatives have been taken by this team, like weekly quiz are conducted, jiska focus hota hai current affairs mein. Also, there are various topics that seem hard to students to grasp. So, media team put stories for explaining those topics in easy ways. They also conduct multiple other quizzes जो कि हेल्प करते हैं स्टूडेंट्स को इन सिविल सर्विस प्रिपरेशन. नॉट ओनली दिस बट ऑल्सो दे गिव लिंक्स टू वेरियस मॉक इंटरव्यूज एंड अदर स्पीचेस दैट कुड बी इम्पॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम सिविल सर्विस प्रिपरेशन. बीइंग पार्ट ऑफ सच अ टीम इन योर कॉलेज लाइफ विल हेल्प यू इन शार्पनिंग योर सोशल मीडिया मार्केटिंग स्किल्स इन बेटर आइडिया जनरेशन कीपिंग अपडेटेड विद सोशल मीडिया एनालिटिक्स एंड यू विल गेट टू लर्न हाउ टू यूज सोशल मीडिया टू योर अटमोस्ट एडवांटेज. Our next team is Public Relation and Marketing team. The Public Relations Department of Exordium works towards public management. It has worked to create framework for our live session series like various speakers ko invite karna to come and speak to our students, sari negotiations, possible sponsorship entities se, coaching institutes se karna and any other possible collaboration. So all these things are looked after by the PR team itself. By working in PR team, you will get to know about corporate world. Aap various reputed persons se contact karoge. This will help you a lot in boosting your confidence, improving your speaking skills and convincing skills. Not only this, but as a PR team volunteer, you will get to know about how to handle situations, how to cultivate quality conversations. It will help in developing negotiation skills, persuasive skills. And the most important, that's going to help you a lot later in corporate world, that is how to withstand criticism and accepting the decisions of person you are dealing with without taking any offense. Ek excellent professional wahi hai jo ki kabhi bhi critic and rejection se discourage na ho jaye. Instead, they embrace and learn from them. So you will learn all such skills by being part of the PR team.
Up next, we have the content team. Well, if you ever came across our page on Instagram, you might have seen posts there. So where does all that content come from? All the facts and stories. So that's where the content team comes in. The content team serves as one very important pillar of this society. The main function of this team is to deliver the right content relevant to UPSC, CSE, put together in a creative manner so that the students can sustain both their interest and attention in several subjects. The team members work wholeheartedly in researching and formulating reliable content the best way possible, ensuring that their work passes through all the quality control checks. Next, we have the logistics team. The logistics team primarily manages the back-end work. They take care of overall organizing and management work, ground sessions, seminars, events, and quizzes, etc. All of these are taken care of by the logistics team. The technical work as well comes under the same team.
The next team is Book Bank team. In market, various books are present, jiski students ko apne preparation ke time pe need hoti hai. But they can't get it, ya to financial limitations ki wajah se, ya lack of knowledge ki wajah se. Book Bank ka aim yahi hai, to reduce this gap and provide everyone with the same resources, jo hamare sare members utilize kar payenge. When situation will get better and college will reopen, then we will make a reading room. Reading room will be a specific area जिसमें students आके अपने exams की preparation कर सकते हैं. Whether it is UPSC, CDS, SSC, CGL, कोई भी exam हो. In that area, you will get study material, books, newspapers, coaching material, magazines, and other material. In short, you are getting area to study. You are getting resources. What could be better than that? Collection, maintenance, and creation of the framework will be the responsibility of the Book Bank team. As this is a new initiative, students will work to create this entire framework. By becoming part of Book Bank team, you will get to know about how to create and how to manage such a big system. Management is one of such topics which have you learned in your textbook, or you might learn that in future, but practical implementation of it is far away than written material. And by becoming part of such a team where you are getting chance to handle and manage entire Book Bank system will give you great exposure in learning managerial skills, which will surely going to help you in the future.
I'm sure all of us, almost all of us, have come across that phase in our life where standing in front of the crowd and speaking was not easy for us. We could feel that adrenaline rush driving us crazy, and we still have those memories, isn't it? So now we have the Personality Development Initiative to help you with this. Self-explanatory by its name, this initiative will encourage students to work on their soft skills by actively participating in debates, discussions, creative writing, extempore and speech delivery, etc. All these activities will improve your skills and eventually enhance your confidence. It will also prepare the students for the long run. So not saying that we're especially focusing on the interview round, but in general, sharpened soft skills and a good personality says a lot about the person.
Next is Inspirigens, Instagram live session series. Inspire with Ingenuity. It is an online Instagram live session series which was presented by Exodium. In this, we interacted with several aces of various civil service examination, ranging from senior IAS officer, IPS officer, IFS officer, SSC CGL toppers, Army veterans, and last year UPSC stoppers. So, ye series kafi beneficial proved hui thi for the students and it helped them with the preparation for civil service examination.
So, Inspirigens can be understood divided into two. So, we had Volume 1 and Volume 2. So, Inspirigens Volume 1 was the first live session of Exordium with various bureaucrats who are working in civil services. Inspirigens is based on an exclusively unique idea brought to reality that involved interaction with various toppers of the past. Our speakers for the first session were IPS Basant Rath, IAS Shubham Gupta, who attained the rank of 6 as per All India rank in the year 2018, IRS Prateet Mishra and Senior IAS Prashant Nair, rank 4 in the year 2007. All of these officers have had a great record of serving selflessly, and having them with us was indeed a great success, garnering views in thousands. The Volume 2 included a comparatively more diverse panel of speakers. We had Army veterans and CSC toppers, while Volume 1's main focus was to enlighten the audience with examination strategies, strategies that would be adopted in preparation for the exam. Volume 2 focused on techniques in general. Inspirigens aims to offer a platform where the students can easily communicate with our guest speakers and receive guidance. In the future series, we plan to have people from different walks of life, people who have been doing exceptionally well in their respective fields and have the potential to enlighten and inspire young minds like us. So this was all about what we've been doing. So what about the future? So we have a lot of more exciting plans for you all to join us in. Majorly, all of them will focus on bringing all the required resources under one roof. We wish to provide the aspirants with all the study material, question papers, and help books, etc., all of it at one place so that the students do not waste their precious time hunting for material. Instead, focus. We want to work hard enough and remove every possible hindrance so that we can ease out your way.
Our first plan is sessions in college. We plan to conduct sessions in college with various speakers, where all the students can get to know the success stories of our speakers and interact with them regarding their doubts. Though online sessions are beneficial, still, there is no match of offline sessions. In these offline sessions, you will interact with speakers personally. If there are any doubts, you can ask from them, and you know who will be the speakers with whom you are getting chance to interact. We plan to invite various bureaucrats, intellectual leaders, judiciary, teachers, civil servants officer, and they will guide you. You will get to know ki civil servants ki life hoti kaisi hai, unka relationship executive and judiciary ke sath kaisa hota hai, and preparation strategies UPSC aspirants ke liye kya ho sakti hai. So in nutshell, you'll get to learn a lot. Management of these session would be looked after by our logistics team. They would take care of overall organizing work. Contacting with our speakers and inviting them for the event would be the responsibility of the public relation and marketing team. They would make sure to invite people from different fields so that they could guide and inspire young minds.
Next, we have the lecture series. So we're planning to approach various teachers par excellence from the University of Delhi and several other universities who are passionate about teaching. A lecture series will be conducted with these teachers where they can teach their respective subjects to students who cannot afford to pay a hefty amount to coaching institutes. To carry out the same thing smoothly, a comprehensive framework will be constructed. So this initiative will be especially very beneficial for those students who will be preparing by themselves. A lot of us have friends in the humanities section who do not go for coaching. In general, a lot of people now, they do face this problem about doubts. So where do they clear it? Now this is their place to get their help.
Our next plan is collaborations with coaching institutes. We would collaborate with coaching institutes and we will try to organize seminars with them. Coaching institutes have wonderful mentors, teachers, and they could guide you really well. Main motive behind arranging seminars with coaching institute is that you get to know ki actually civil services hai kya, SSC CGL kya hai, CDS kya hai. So you get to know about these exams better and you could make up your mind regarding these exams. You can clarify your doubts regarding it. After clarifying about exams and setting your mind ki hame kya karna hai future mein, the next struggle, or could I say a big confusing thing, is which coaching institute shall you join? So we are trying to reduce your confusions, and by our collaboration with different coaching institutes, we will help you in providing details about different institutes, like kaun sa coaching center kya provide kar raha hai, batch size kya hai, course structure kya hai, fees kya hai, and all such questions regarding institutes. It would be better to choose which institute you should join when you get details about all possible best options available. You could decide whether coaching institute will be helpful to join or not. If it is, then which institute shall you join? You could distinguish among different institutes, so you will be able to choose best option for you. Not only this, but through our partnership, we would also try to provide you some study material from these coaching institutes. Next is our Exodium recruitment. How to become part of Exodium? So our registration process depends on why you wish to join the society. Do you want to join Exodium as a learning member? That is, you want guidance for preparation of civil service examination? Or do you want to join the society as a volunteer to become part of this team? Or both as a learning member as well as a volunteer? So if you wish to join Exodium as learning member, then you just have to fill registration form. On the other hand, if you wish to join Exodium as a volunteer, along with filling of registration form, you have to go through other two routes. So now let me explain you about this form and other routes. First of all, registration form. So registration form will be rolled out soon after orientation session end. In that registration form, questions would be like, firstly, personal information like your name, contact details, course, etc. would be asked. There would be situational related questions too in the form that you need to answer. It would be like a situation would be given to you and then you have to answer what would you do if you were in that situation. Then there would be one or two questions that would be related to your personality and that would help us to know you all better. So if you wish to join Exodium as a learning member, your registration process ends here. But if you wish to join as volunteer, other two rounds are waiting for you. Next round to become part of Exodium is group discussion round. Those who got selected in application form round would be divided in some small groups. So har group ko ek situation provide ki jayegi. To entire group ko discussions karna hai and they have to come to some conclusions or some final solution. So we will see your contributions to come to final solutions, how you worked in a team, who gave better ideas. We will assess your thought process, problem solving skills, and your reasoning caliber. So keeping in mind all these factors, some students would be selected for the last round, that is personal interview round. In interview, questions relating to information you gave in form, relating to teams that you wanted to be part of, relating to your strengths, weaknesses, your personality will be asked. And after that final round, best out of all the applicants will be selected and will become part of our Exodium family. We are now open for questions. You all can type them in the chat box.
guys, anyone of you have any queries about Exodium or any of your questions are not answered till now, you all can put it up in the chat box.
Are the co-hosts able to see the questions in the chat section? Because I'm able to see quite a few questions. So I just want to ask you guys.
Yeah, Shreyash, we can see them.
All right, perfect.
So the question, one question I got is, what is the duration to sell? Yogesh, would you like to answer?
Shyam, you just said something.
Someone has asked a question. What is duration to the cell? To this cell.
Okay. So once you are enrolled in the Exodium cell, of course the duration is 1 year, and you can continue. Like if you are in first year or second year or third year, you will be joining it for a year, and if you want to continue it for the next year, it's upon you. It's your decision. But yeah, the minimum duration is 1 year.
So someone asked me a question, if we don't clear the second or third round, can we still be part of society as a volunteer? So I would like to answer this question. Basically, agar tum second or third round ko clear nahi kar pate, to aap as a member rahoge, but as a volunteer nahi ho paoge. Ab basically, what is the difference between member and volunteer? I think aapko pehle samajh mein aa gaya hoga. Agar usme bhi agar koi confusion, main in short bata deta hu. Members are only those students who are here to utilize the resources, and volunteers are those students who want to construct resources. Basically, wo log jo resources bana rahe hain, like alag alag teams mein jo log honge, and member normal student hai jo resources utilize kar raha hai, but volunteers ko aur benefits bhi hota hai, jaise unko certificate milega and everything like that. Aapko personality development mein bahut help milti hai as a volunteer, to but ha thoda time devote karna padega har society mein, kyunki aap resource generate karoge, aap aise events plan karoge, aapke khud ke contacts honge, matlab ban jayenge dheere dheere jab aap pr team ke part hoge, and except that choice is yours in last, hamesha choice tumhari rahegi, so just think about that. Okay, then how many seats are there to be a learning member? Someone asked me, so you Mac, आप आंसर दे दो इस क्वेश्चन का।
शिवम, कैन यू प्लीज रिपीट द क्वेश्चन, बिकॉज़ आई कैन सी इट।
हाउ मेनी सीट्स आर देयर टू बी लर्निंग मेंबर? सो मैं बता देता हूं इसका, कि बेसिकली ऐसी कोई फिक्स नंबर ऑफ सीट्स है नहीं, दैट विल डिपेंड ऑन योर क्वालिटी ऑफ आंसर. बेसिकली देखो, फॉर्म में हम ये नहीं देख रहे कि आपकी इंग्लिश, आपकी लैंग्वेज कितनी अच्छी है, बट व्हाट वी वांट इज कि आप कितने सीरियस हो, बिकॉज़ आप फॉर्म कैसे भर रहे हो उससे हमें आइडिया लग जाएगा कि आप कितने सीरियस हो. इफ यू आर अ सीरियस स्टूडेंट जो लिटरली परस्यू करना चाहते हैं, देन फ्रॉम योर फॉर्म्स हमको इतना क्लियर तो हो ही जाएगा. तो ये, एंड मोस्ट प्रोबेबली, नॉट श्योर बट आई एम सेइंग मोस्ट प्रोबेबली, वॉलंटियर्स को अटेंडेंस भी कॉलेज से मिल जाएगी. मतलब 17% अटेंडेंस इन स्टॉक आप लोगों को एज अ वॉलंटियर आपको मिल जाएगी. देन प्रियंका एज अ question, do you provide proper strategy for this exam? So main kiska answer tum de do?
Proper strategy as in there are a lot of strategies. Am I audible?
Ha, you are audible.
Okay, so hum log proper strategies as in ek strategy nahi hoti hai civil services ya koi bhi exam crack karne ke liye. We are going to provide you a lot of resources jisse aap use crack kar paoge. So हम लोग आपको फैसिलिटीज प्रोवाइड करेंगे, स्ट्रेटजीज आर आल्सो गोना बी अ पार्ट ऑफ इट, बट नो श्योर शॉट स्ट्रेटजी विल बी देयर.
देखो, स्ट्रेटजी का सीन होता है, हर इंसान की खुद की एक स्ट्रेटजी होती है. मैक ने जो बोला काफी सही है कि हम, आप देखो यार, हर किसी की एक विजन होता है, हर किसी की एक कैलिबर होता है, एक कैपेबिलिटी होती है. अब आपका क्या कैलिबर है, आपके क्या प्लस है, क्या आपके माइनस है, वो हम भी डिसाइड नहीं कर सकते. हम जितना हम जैसे गाइडेंस दिला सकते हैं, और जैसा भी आपको पता चला होगा, हमारे लिए भी अनएक्सपेक्टेड था जो सर संजीव सर ने हमको सरप्राइज दिया कि हमको लबासना से डायरेक्ट हेल्प मिला करेगी, वहां से आईएएस ऑफिसर डायरेक्टली हमको पढ़ाएंगे. तो आई थिंक कि किसी भी कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट से काफी ज्यादा प्रोग्रेसिव पॉइंट पे हम हैं. एंड नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम पूर्वा. आई एम स्टूडेंट ऑफ बीकॉम ऑनर्स. व्हिच सब्जेक्ट सब्जेक्ट शुड आई चूज एज माय जीई. व्हिच वुड बी बेनिफिशियल फॉर मी फॉर दिस प्रिपरेशन. सो योगेश आप इसका आंसर देना चाहोगे? मैं दूं.
यू कैन कंटिन्यू. या
ओके. सो पूर्वा देखो जी में ऐसा सब्जेक्ट डिपेंड करता है तुम्हें किस सब्जेक्ट में हेल्प चाहिए, तुम्हारे स्ट्रॉन्ग क्या है, तुम्हारे वीक्स क्या है. इनफैक्ट एक मैं बहुत नॉर्मल बात बता रहा हूँ, साइंस के स्टूडेंट जो पूरे साल साइंस पढ़ते हैं वो भी यूपीएससी क्लियर करते हैं, वो भी आर्ट्स वाले सब्जेक्ट की तरह. मैं खुद कई लोगों को ऐसे को जानता हूँ जिन्हें बीटेक करी थी, देन उन्होंने एक साल डेढ़ साल का ड्रॉप लिया. मैं ये नहीं कह रहा उन्होंने कोचिंग करी या नहीं करी, एंड उस ड्रॉप में उनने सब्जेक्ट आर्ट्स के ही लिए, उनने बीटेक करी है, साइंस उनको आती है बट फिर भी वो सब्जेक्ट आर्ट्स के ले रहे हैं. तो वो आई थिंक तुम पर डिपेंड करेगा कि तुम्हें जी में क्या लेना चाहिए, बिकॉज जी में इतना सफिशियंट तुम नहीं पढ़ोगे कि तुम यूपीएससी क्लियर कर लोगे, वो तुम्हें खुद की तरफ से करना पड़ेगा. बट हाँ ये है कि अगर तुम कोई लाइट सब्जेक्ट लेती हो या कोई ऐसा सब्जेक्ट जो तुम अपने ऑप्शनल में लेना चाहती हो तो तुम्हें थोड़ी हेल्प मिल जाएगी, थोड़ी सी हेल्प, बहुत ज्यादा नहीं. एंड फिर वो तो फाइनली आपके लक और पेपर सेटर के माइंड पर डिपेंड करता है हर एंट्रेंस एग्जाम का.
Abhishek Jain is asking, if we join as a learner, will we be able to attend all the personality development seminars, etc.? Abhishek Jain, you will get access to everything. It is just that ki it's a management part. If you join as a member of Exodium rather than a volunteer, if you join as a volunteer, you will be part of the management. You will be managing all these personal development seminars. You will be approaching to speakers. You will be managing the content. You will be getting all the newspapers done every single morning. You will be researching out for the content that is to be going on social media. So, aap administration wali side pe ho jaoge Exodium ke if you are as a volunteer. But if you are just as a member of the cell, you will get everything. So, there is not any exclusive access to all the volunteers. It is just that volunteers will be actively managing everything. So they get to know, they get to learn something's extra. So yeah.
So someone has asked me, what are the probable topics that will be asked in the GD? Basically, ऐसा कोई fix topics अभी तक हमने decide नहीं करे कि क्या GD में हम पूछेंगे. But I will say you कि कुछ current affairs related जो literally तुम्हें लग रहा है logical हो. मतलब logical अब ऐसे तो कोई देखो हमेशा एक बात बताता हूँ, एक बहुत basic बात है. मैं नहीं कह रहा खाली इस एग्जाम के लिए, कोई भी कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम हो आपके पास ऐसा क्वेश्चन नहीं आने वाला, मतलब बेसिकली नेगेटिव क्वेश्चन नहीं आने वाले करंट अफेयर में. नेगेटिव न्यूज कभी आपके काम की नहीं होती. नेगेटिव न्यूज इज कि यहाँ पे डाका पड़ा, यहाँ पे रॉबरी हुई, यहाँ पे इतने लोग मर गए, ऐसे कोई भी क्वेश्चन ना जीडी में पूछे जाएंगे, बिकॉज एग्जामिनेशन वॉन्ट टू सी योर पॉजिटिव साइड, योर पॉजिटिव थिंकिंग. आपकी पॉजिटिव अप्रोच देखने से नेगेटिव अप्रोच नहीं देखनी. सो फॉर दैट रीजन ना जीडी में और ना यहाँ की मतलब एक्सोडियम की जीडी में और ना ही क्या कहते हैं किसी भी कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम में नेगेटिव चीज कुछ भी नहीं पूछी जाएगी. तो आई विल सजेस्ट यू जितने भी होते हैं ना मसालेदार न्यूज जिन्हें कहते हैं लोग, उन न्यूजों को स्किप करो, वो तुम्हारे काम के लिए. आगे अगला क्वेश्चन है, डिफरेंस बीइंग अ मेंबर एंड अ वॉलंटियर एंड बोथ. सो ये महक तुम बता दो तो डिफरेंस क्या है मेंबर वॉलंटियर बोथ होने में.
एज अ मेंबर आप लोग सिर्फ रिसोर्सेज एक्सेस कर सकते हैं एंड आप कुछ प्लानिंग एंड ऑल में नहीं होंगे, बट एज अ वॉलंटियर आप बहुत चीज़ें प्लान कर रहे होंगे हमारे साथ एंड बोथ आप उसके लिए अप्लाई कर सकते हैं, देन आपको दोनों चीज़ें फैसिलिटेट होंगी.
ओके सो आई गॉट अ क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इफ समवन वांट्स टू बी अ पार्ट एज अ लर्नर एंड वॉलंटियर बट कुडंट क्लियर द अदर टू राउंड्स ऑफ बीइंग अ वॉलंटियर. What will be the final decision regarding this student's entry?
अगर आप दोनों चीजों के लिए apply कर रहे हो as a volunteer and as a member, अगर तुम्हारा basic form जो है last के दो round तो GD and interview हटाओ, अगर तुम्हारा basic round clear हो गया तो member तो sure for sure. If you want to be one member, अब कई लोग हैं जैसे मैं बताता हूँ, Exodium का PR department touchwood काफी strong हो गया in last 8 months. एंड काफी ज्यादा एक्सपीरियंस, मतलब ऐसे नहीं कि और सोसाइटीज के आई एम सेइंग वीक है, बट होता ना कि इनिशियल पॉइंट के हिसाब से हमें काफी अच्छा स्टाफ वो मिल गया. सो एज अ मेंबर आप अपने पीआर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स बनाना सीखोगे. कई लोग जिनको यूपीएससी में बिल्कुल भी इंटरेस्ट नहीं वो भी आ सकते हैं एज अ वॉलंटियर ओनली फॉर सर्टिफिकेट वाला पर्पज, बिकॉज
आई थिंक सर्टिफिकेट सबको यही चाहिए होते हैं, बट आई विल से कि खाली सर्टिफिकेट के लिए मत आना, लिटरली अगर काम करना चाहते हो देन ही आना, एंड नॉट ओनली इन दिस सोसाइटी, इन एनी सोसाइटी, चाहे वो WDC, NSS, MAC, अगर खाली सर्टिफिकेट के लेके आ जाओगे, बट बेसिकली उन सोसाइटी तुम्हें पता हो सर्टिफिकेट की वैल्यू क्यों है, किसी भी सर्टिफिकेट की वैल्यू क्यों है, बिकॉज उस वो सर्टिफिकेट बताता है कि इंसान को ये काम आता है। अगर आप एक फर्जी सर्टिफिकेट, मतलब एक ऐसा सर्टिफिकेट जिसके लिए आप लाए कि नहीं, आपने काम ही नहीं करा, एंड देन यू गो विद दैट सर्टिफिकेट, तो आपको शायद इनिशियल टाइम पे पुश मिल जाएगा, बट थोड़े टाइम बाद आप उसी लेवल पे आ जाओगे जो सर्टिफिकेट के बिना आप होते हैं। तो ये हर सोसाइटी के लिए एकदम होता है ना, हर सोसाइटी पे फिट बैठता है ये चीज। सो आई विल सजेस्ट यू सर्टिफिकेट के लिए किसी भी सोसाइटी में मत जाओ, काम के लिए जाओगे तो बहुत सही है, तुम्हें एक्सपीरियंस मिलेगा, एंड एक्सपीरियंस तो काफी मिलेगा इसमें, क्योंकि बहुत सारे अलग अलग वास्ट डिपार्टमेंट्स हैं, क्योंकि सिंगल फोकस चीज नहीं है। नहीं बस अगला है, हिंदी मीडियम के लिए न्यूज़पेपर कौन सा बेस्ट रहेगा, उषा देवी ने क्वेश्चन पूछा है। सो मैम बात न्यूज़पेपर की नहीं होती, बात आती है आपके बेसिकली कौन सा वाला पार्ट होता है वो, मैं बोल रहा हूँ एडिटोरियल पार्ट जो होता है हर न्यूज़पेपर का, उसके ऊपर आती है। सो आई विल से कि न्यूज़पेपर में कैसे बोलूँ यार, हिंदी के लिए हर स्टेट में अलग न्यूज़पेपर आ रहा होता है, इसलिए मैं क्लियर नहीं बता पाऊंगा इस क्वेश्चन का आंसर, बट शायद ये क्वेश्चन हम, हाँ हमारे जो गेस्ट आए थे उनसे, जिनसे मेरे को भी आफ्टर दिस मीटिंग बात करनी, उनसे मैं पूछ लूंगा।
ओके, सो मनिका इज आस्किंग दैट इज देयर एनी पर्सन अमंग यू हु बोथ अ वॉलंटियर एंड अ मेंबर आस्किंग सो दैट आई कैन गेट अ सजेशन एज टू शुड वी गो फॉर बोथ। मनिका, इफ देयर आर टू पोजीशन लाइक मेंबर एंड अ वॉलंटियर, if you are a volunteer you will get of course a certificate of being a volunteer, and if you are a member you will get a certificate of being a member only, but apart from certificates, if you are a volunteer you get to everything, you get access to everything that a member
no has. Member don't have any certificate.
Okay ma'am, sorry
Yogesh, members ke liye I think koi bhi certificate nahi hai.
Okay,
khali volunteers ka hai. Okay, cool. College will provide all the certificate for volunteers.
Okay, yeah, so as you corrected me, only volunteers will be getting the certificates of being a Exodium volunteer, and being a member you can have access to all the opportunities and all the benefits that Exodium is giving everyone in the Exodium, but yeah, like if you are a volunteer you are already like above the members, because you are already managing and everything which will be given to the members. So I think directly speaking, you can, if you are a volunteer you need not to become a member only, am I right Shiv?
How much time is needed to be devoted? What type of certificate will be provided? Remember, एक सेकेंड। Sources सारे सेम होंगे, मतलब आपको जो लोग UPSC, SSC, CDS किसी भी एग्जाम के लिए प्रिपेयर कर रहे हैं उनको सोर्सेज सारे बराबर मिलेंगे, ऐसा नहीं है कि वॉलंटियर को कुछ एक्स्ट्रा बेनिफिट मिलने वाले हैं इन द मीन ऑफ सोर्सेज, सो उस चीज की टेंशन मत लो, क्योंकि ऐसे कोई डिस्क्रिमिनेट नहीं करने वाला एक्सोडियम किसी के भी साथ कि भाई तुम वॉलंटियर नहीं हो तो तुम्हारे जो सोर्सेज मिले सोर्सेज सबको। सेकंड क्वेश्चन है, एज अ मेंबर शुड बी एबल, ओके व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सर्टिफिकेट नीड टू बी, हाउ टू बिकम बी अ पार्ट ऑफ एक्सोडियम एंड व्हेन यू सेंड द फॉर्म एंड ऑल डिटेल एंड वेयर वी फाइंड ऑल थिंग, स्टिल आई not join any society because I am exploring and now I think I found but does not how to join and can you again explain about the rounds, so is question ka answer mai tum dena chahoge?
Yeah sure,
basically teen question ek saath puch liye hai,
nahi
how to become part of Exodium and when you... okay
ओके सो पहले आप हमारे कॉलेज में हो तो सबके CRs फॉर्म सर्कुलेट करते हैं, तो ऑब्वियसली आपके क्लास ग्रुप में भी आ ही जाएगा, तो आपको उसमें एनरोल करना है, देन उसमें ऑप्शन होगा टू बी एज अ मेंबर, वॉलंटियर और बोथ, तो आपको जो भी सिलेक्ट करना है आप उसमें से सिलेक्ट कर सकते हो। देन इफ यू सिलेक्ट फॉर वॉलंटियर देन और अपकमिंग राउंड होंगे जिसमें डिस्कशन ग्रुप डिस्कशन राउंड होगा, इंटरव्यू राउंड होगा, एंड उनके बेसिस पे आपको सिलेक्शन दिया जाएगा।
नहीं 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 ओके उषा देवी ने पूछा है वॉलंटियर सर्टिफिकेट यूपीएससी इंटरव्यू में हेल्प करते हैं क्या. बेसिकली आपका हर एक सर्टिफिकेट, मैं ये नहीं कहूंगा कि फॉर श्योर हेल्प करते हैं, बट वो सर्टिफिकेट बताते कि इस इंसान को ये आता है, मतलब एक बार को, फिर वो आपका इंटरव्यू लेके बाकी सब पता कर ही लेंगे. सो आई विल नॉट से कि फॉर श्योर सर्टिफिकेट हेल्प करते हैं, बट डिपेंड करता है आपका कौन सा सर्टिफिकेट है. अब मैं एक बात बताता हूँ, मैनी ऑफ यू आर फ्रेशर्स, इनफैक्ट मैनी ऑफ यू आर इन सेकेंड ईयर ऑल्सो, सो आपको काफ़ी सारे ऑप्शन मिलेंगे. जैसे कई बार होता है आप कॉलेज के बाहर मतलब इवेंट्स होंगे एंड आपको बोलेंगे कि वॉलंटियर कर लो, वॉलंटियर का सर्टिफिकेट, मतलब इवेंट्स वॉलंटियरिंग, जैसे आपको जाके वहाँ पर बस उनकी रजिस्ट्रेशन लिस्ट संभालनी है, इस टाइप का काम है, तो उसके सर्टिफिकेट को ऐसा फायदा नहीं देते. बट अगर आपके सर्टिफिकेट में लिखा है कि आप इस डिपार्टमेंट के पार्ट रहे हो, तो वो चीज़ आपको किसी भी सोसाइटी का हो वो चीज़ थोड़ा प्लस पॉइंट दिखाएगी, बिकॉज वो बताएगी कि आपको ये वाला काम आता है. जैसे मैं पी आर टीम का काम हूँ, तो मतलब मेरे को पब्लिक रिलेशन मेंटेन करना आता है, पब्लिक रिलेशन बनाना आता है. तो ऐसे ही हर इंसान का अलग अलग होता है कि आपने क्या काम करा है, उस हिसाब से आपको फायदा मिलेगा. ओके, सजेशन एनी अदर सोसाइटी विच वी शुड बी ज्वाइन एंड हेल्प फॉर अस एज इफ वी गेट इफ वी आर यूपीएससी एस्पिरेंट. सो मैम, कोई भी सोसाइटी आपके चॉइस के ऊपर डिपेंड करती है. अगर आप उस सोसाइटी के फंक्शनिंग में बिलीव करते हो और आपको लगता है कि आप वही काम करना चाहते हो, तो आप किसी सोसाइटी को ज्वाइन करो. एंड प्लीज किसी सोसाइटी को यूपीएससी के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से ज्वाइन मत करो, बिकॉज मैं बताता हूँ, शुभम गुप्ता आए थे हमारे, मेरे को याद है उनका इंटरव्यू मैंने लिया था, ही इज फ्रॉम जयपुर, सो फ्रॉम माई सिटी. सो उनने एक बात बोली थी एंड वो मेरे को बहुत अच्छी लगी थी कि वो खुद डी यू के पास आउट थे, देन उनने फिर डी यू से शायद आई थिंक एम ए करी थी, सो नहीं लॉ करी थी डी यू से, हाँ. तो उनने एक बात कही थी जो मेरे को काफ़ी अच्छी लगी थी कि सोसाइटीज आपके ओवरऑल डेवलपमेंट में पार्ट करती हैं, बट एज सच ये नहीं कि आपको उससे इंटरव्यू में बेनिफिट मिलने वाला है, बट इंटरव्यू में बैठने के लिए जो क्वालिटीज चाहिए, जो कॉन्फिडेंस चाहिए, वो चीज़ें काफ़ी हद तक आपको सोसाइटी दे जाती है. मैं ये नहीं कह रहा कि एक्सोडियम ही खाली, बट एनी सोसाइटी इफ यू एक्टिवली पार्टिसिपेट इन दैट. Then someone asked me, I want to join WDC, I had already filled its form. If I join the Exodium Society, will it be okay to join both society or to join single society, also keeping in mind the academic match honors. So, ठीक है, जिन लोगों को ये लगता है कि एक टाइम पे एक सोसाइटी करनी चाहिए ज़्यादा, तो मैं बता देता हूँ, डिपेंड करता है आप अपने टाइम मैनेजमेंट को कैसे करते हो. क्योंकि मैंने खुद ने काफ़ी सोसाइटीज में पार्ट रहा हूँ, काफ़ी इवेंट्स में पार्ट रहा हूँ. जैसे फर्स्ट ईयर मैं यूथ कॉन्क्लेव में था, मैं टेडएक्स में था, देन मैं साइंस फेयर में था, सेकंड ईयर में विस्तार में रहा, देन WDC में फर्स्ट ईयर में से था, NSS में मैं सेकंड ईयर में था, EOC में मैं एग्जीक्यूटिव मेंबर था, केमिस्ट्री की जो सोसाइटी हमारी उसमें मैं रहा हूँ फर्स्ट ईयर में. देन आई थिंक मैंने मतलब काफ़ी सोसाइटी एक्सप्लोर करी है, कुछ हो मैं डायरेक्टली जिनमें मैं था, कुछ मैं अपने दोस्तों की वजह से जाता था. जैसे इस साल में मैं कभी नहीं रहा, बट मेरे काफ़ी दोस्त थे तो उनकी वजह से मैं थोड़ा उनके साथ काम करने जाता, मेरे को अच्छा लगता था. तो टाइम मैनेजमेंट, एंड खुद मैं केमिस्ट्री ओनर से हूँ, तो ये चीज़ दिमाग में मतलब रखो कि यार हम इस डिपार्टमेंट से हैं तो हम मैनेज कर पाएंगे नहीं कर पाएंगे, मैनेजमेंट फुली तुम्हारे ऊपर डिपेंडेंट है, ठीक है. और सोसाइटी में, एक सोसाइटी में होना, दो सोसाइटी में, मैं कह रहा हूँ अगर तुम मैनेज कर सकते हो तुम आठ सोसाइटी में जाओ, आठ में भी कोई नहीं रुक रहा, बट बात है कि जिस सोसाइटी में आप हो उसमें आपको, देखो आपने अप्लाई करा, हमने आपके इंटरव्यू लिया, एक भरोसा है हर सोसाइटी के आप पे एक भरोसा है कि आप उसके लिए काम करोगे. क्योंकि ये सोसाइटी चलती है किससे, कोई स्पेशल बाहर से कोई सैलरी नहीं दे रहे, हम लोग ही इसको चलाते हैं विदाउट, खाली एक सर्टिफिकेट है. एंड आई थिंक एक सर्टिफिकेट इतनी बड़ी चीज नहीं है जिसके लिए हम अपने एक साल वोट करेंगे, बट आई थिंक इसकी वो फैमिली वाला पार्ट मैंने बताया था मेरी स्पीच में, अगर आपने सुना होगा, नहीं सुना तो मैं बता देता हूँ कि हर एक उसमें आपको एक कॉमन इंटरेस्ट के लोग मिलते हैं और वो कॉमन इंटरेस्ट आपको एक फैमिली वाली फीलिंग दे देता है. तो आई विल सजेस्ट यू सोसाइटीज को इसलिए मत ज्वाइन करो क्योंकि आपको लगता है कि उसके सर्टिफिकेट आपके काम आएंगे, सोसाइटीज को इसलिए ज्वाइन करो जिससे आपको एक नई आपके कॉमन इंटरेस्ट वाली फैमिली मिले. देन क्वेश्चन और एक और है, शुड आई एक्स्ट्रा गेट टू पार्ट ऑफ स्पेसिफिक ग्रुप ऑफ स्टूडेंट प्रिपरेशन फॉर सर्टेन एग्जाम्स. सुषमा ने क्वेश्चन पूछा है, आई एम ऑलरेडी पार्ट ऑफ एक्सोडियम एज अ मेंबर, ओके, सो शुड आई, देखो अगर आप रजिस्ट्रेशन करते हो तो आप वॉलंटियर के लिए वापस कर सकते हो, ऐसा कोई वो नहीं है कि जो मेंबर है वॉलंटियर के लिए नहीं कर सकते, तो यू कैन डू इट फॉर सेम. बट ऐसा नहीं कि देखो हम ट्राई करेंगे जो आपने ग्रुप भरा है, जो भी टीम भरी है वो आपको प्रोवाइड कराने की, बट नॉट फॉर श्योर उस टाइम आपसे पूछा जाएगा अगर आपको दूसरे ग्रुप में डाला जाता है तो आपसे बात करके ही किया जाएगा. मनिका खंडेलवाल, इफ आई बिकम अ पार्ट ऑफ डांस सोसाइटी विल आई बी एबल टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट इक्वली टू एक्सोडियम एज अ वॉलंटियर? इसका आंसर महक और योगेश में से कोई देना चाहेगा? मैं ही दूं, जस्ट आस्किंग गाइस.
आई कांट सी द क्वेश्चन.
मैं बता देता हूं, इफ आई बिकम अ पार्ट ऑफ डांस सोसाइटी विल आई एबल टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट इक्वली टू एक्सोडियम एज अ वॉलंटियर?
तिशा गुप्ता एज वेल एज मनिका खंडेलवाल हैव समथिंग सेम क्वेश्चन. Basically, they want to ask कि अगर हम join करते हैं Exodium, I want Shivam to answer this. If we join Exodium, how much effort is gonna take? How much hectic it will be? In numbers, how much time it will take per hour? Oh, sorry, per week or per month?
Yeah, ये काफी difficult question है, because we are also not sure about this. अभी तक हम initial moment देखो, अब काफी हद तक stability आ चुकी society में, and I will not say कि बहुत ज़्यादा. अगर तुम per month बोल रहे हो, I am giving an approximate data. Maybe कुछ क्योंकि कभी इवेंट होता है तो थोड़ा ज्यादा हो जाता है, और कभी इवेंट नहीं होता तो काफी कम भी हो जाता है. जैसे एग्जाम्स के फाइनल अपने सेमेस्टर एग्जाम्स होते हैं या इंटरनल्स के टाइम पे, हर सोसाइटी अपना फंक्शनिंग थोड़ा कम कर देती है जिससे स्टूडेंट्स की रिजल्ट डिस्टर्ब ना हो, रिजल्ट इफेक्ट ना हो. बट कभी कभी अब सपोज करो कि इन एनी इवेंट हमारा कोई इवेंट सडनली ऐसा आ गया जिसमें काफी अच्छा कोई गेस्ट आ रहा है, तो थोड़ा सा आई थिंक कभी हो सकता है. नहीं तो फोर अप्रॉक्समेट कैसे बोलूं यार, थोड़ा डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन है क्योंकि पर इसमें एवरेज कुछ भी नहीं चलता. मैं बताता हूँ, इट इज डिपेंडेंट कि आप किस टीम में, पहली बात. एंड सेकंड थिंग कि अब जैसे लॉकडाउन टाइम है, लॉजिस्टिक टीम का बहुत कम काम है एंड मीडिया मार्केटिंग का काम ज्यादा है. जब लॉकडाउन खत्म होगा एंड जब कॉलेज में सेमिनार्स अटेंड मैनेज होंगे, इवेंट्स अरेंज होंगे, तो उस टाइम लॉजिस्टिक का काम बढ़ जाएगा, मीडिया मार्केटिंग का शायद थोड़ा कम हो जाएगा. तो ऐसे काम चलते हैं, पीआर का काम इवेंट से पहले होता है और इवेंट के टाइम वो फ्री. बाकी बाकी मीडिया मार्केटिंग का काम तो आई थिंक हर टाइम ही चलता है, क्योंकि उनको वो देखो वो एकदम ही रियल होता है ना कि हमारा फेस है. बट हाँ, टीम भी हम लोग उस हिसाब से बनाई है सारी, ऐसा नहीं कि हम लोग इक्वल वॉलंटियर सब में डालें. टीम उस हिसाब से होगी जिस हिसाब से आप टाइम मैनेज कर सको. हमको पता है कि किस टीम पर वर्कलोड ज्यादा होने वाला है, तो इन दैट मैनर हमने उसी टीम में ज्यादा वॉलंटियर्स रख दिए जिससे ज्यादा वर्कलोड ना बढ़े. टाइम मेंबर और वॉलंटियर मेंबर, तो देखो मेंबर्स को तो हम फैसिलिटी प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं, वो आपको कितना टाइम देना है वो हम नहीं बता सकते. एंड मैं बोलूँ एक वॉलंटियर का नाम एट मैक्स बोल रहा हूँ, मतलब जितना मैंने फील करा है, अब तक एक्सपीरियंस करा है, 2 घंटे एक दिन में हद से ज्यादा. वो भी मतलब होता है ना, वो भी कभी कभी ऐसा होगा कि पर्टिकुलर एक वीक जिसमें तुम्हें 2 घंटे शायद देने पड़ रहे होंगे, नहीं तो आधा पौन घंटे का काम भी नहीं होता डेली वाला. अगर आप रेगुलरली अपना काम करो, अगर आप एवरेजली उसको डिवाइड कर दोगे तो आई थिंक एक दिन में 1 घंटा.
लाइक आई मायसेल्फ एम अ वॉलंटियर एंड मेरे हिसाब से ऑल्दो वर्कलोड इज सीजनल, मतलब अगर कोई इवेंट है तो उससे एक दो दिन पहले ऑफकोर्स काम ज्यादा होगा, बट ऑन एन एवरेज इफ आई से इट विल नॉट टेक मोर देन 10 आवर्स, लाइक मैक्सिमम 10 आवर्स पर वीक.
कंटेंट किस कोचिंग से रिलेटेड होगा? तो उषा, आई वुड लाइक टू आंसर कि कंटेंट कोई सिलेक्टेड कोचिंग से रिलेटेड नहीं होगा. कंटेंट अलग अलग सोर्स से होगा, वो भी जो हमको सही लगेगा. इनफैक्ट हमारी कंटेंट सिलेक्शन टीम में उसका काम पता है क्या है? सबसे ज्यादा मतलब सबसे अच्छा काम भी उसका ही लगता है, क्योंकि वो जो खुद पढ़ रहे हैं, जो खुद के नोट्स बना रहे हैं, वही नोट्स उनको थोड़ा फॉर्मल मैनर में औरों को भी देना होता है. तो कई बार तो हम खुद के कई टॉपिक्स पे तो हम खुद का कंटेंट जनरेट कर रहे हैं. इंस्टाग्राम पे जाओगे आपको जो कंटेंट मिलेगा वो सारा खुद का जनरेट करा हुआ है, ठीक है. एंड हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश मीडियम का व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप, देखो हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश मीडियम का व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप अलग अलग नहीं बन पाएगा, डिपेंड करता है हमारे पास वॉलंटियर्स कैसे हैं, क्योंकि वी विल ट्राई रिसोर्सेज एट मैक्स जनरेट करने का. एट मैक्स बनाने का, बट इतना भी हम मतलब क्योंकि खुद हम भी स्टूडेंट्स हैं, तुम भी स्टूडेंट्स हो गए, तुम भी पार्ट मेंबर बनते हो, तो तुम भी सोच के देख लो कि यार डिपेंड करेगा कि मेंबर्स वॉलंटियर्स कितने होते हैं, उस हिसाब से डिपेंड करेगा कितने मेंबर्स आ रहे हैं, कितने वॉलंटियर्स हैं, फिर उस हिसाब से वी विल ट्राई कि हाँ मटेरियल को उस हिसाब से डिवाइड करने का. We are auditory selected as a member. Yes, someone has asked me if we want to be a volunteer and we are rejected in GD, then we are already selected as a member. So, iska answer mehak tum de do.
Yes, of course. Agar aap volunteer wale round mein agar nahi kar paate ho, then aap member hamare of course rahoge.
But seriously, ek baat, agar member wale group mein aa rahe ho, to please thoda serious hoke karna. Matlab, umeed hai yaar, expectations hone mat hona. अब आई थिंक कि हम तीन क्वेश्चन पुट करने वाले हैं, देन फिर आप क्या कहते हैं इंस्टाग्राम पे मैसेज कर लेना, वहाँ पे वहाँ से आपको रिप्लाई मिल जाएगा, या आपको फॉर्म के साथ साथ काफ़ी सारे कुछ नंबर्स मिलेंगे तो आप उन पर भी कांटेक्ट कर सकते हो. डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट गाइस. अगर आपको और कोई क्वेश्चन है तो पूछ लो, नहीं तो फिर आई थिंक कि हमको वाइंड अप कर देना चाहिए.
Before ending, I would say, guys, make sure you follow exodium.svc on Instagram, ताकि whatever we are doing, you get to know agar kuch recruitment forms aa rahe hain, kuch bhi ho raha hai.
I'm not saying ki tum follow karo na karo, but continue check karte rehna, fir pata chale ki tumse deadline miss ho rahi hai, and then you are calling us ki bhaiya ye reh gaya ya ye ho gaya. To I will suggest you follow karna na, because follow karne se kya tumko continue notification aate rahenge, but ab kai log hota hai jinko apne follower and following ka bahut zyada wo tension hota hai. तो उनको मैं कहूंगा कि हाँ कंटिन्यू चेक करते रहना. ओके, सो अब उसके बाद आई विल इनवाइट रितिका फॉर वोट ऑफ थैंक्स. सो रितिका, यू कैन कम एंड प्लीज कंटिन्यू.
यस, थैंक यू शिवम. सो आई वुड नाउ लाइक टू टेक अ मोमेंट एंड थैंक ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर योर रैप पेशेंस एंड अटेंशन विद व्हिच यू ऑल अटेंडेड दिस सेशन. आई एम श्योर यू गाइस लर्नड अ लॉट अबाउट एक्सोडियम एंड कुड गेट योर डाउट्स क्लियर्ड. इन केस If you still have any doubts, please feel free reaching out to us through our Instagram page or by the numbers that will be given to you. So with warm wishes and warm regards, we end this session. Thank you so much for joining us and stay tuned for more updates. Thank you.